Hello friends, I'm Urvasshi. Welcome to my channel. If you're seeing one of my videos for the first time, then remember to subscribe. The subscription button is right here. Remember to subscribe. Give me a thumbs up if you like what you hear. And if you're already liking what you're hearing, then you can give me a thumbs up straight away. But remember to give me one anyways. And give me your feedback. You can leave a comment in the comment section. So today in this video, I'm going to be talking about activation of the luck factor in the horoscope. In fact, I've already made 3 videos on this. This is the 4th one. So the luck factor lies in the 9th house. The 9th house is a lot of things. Other than luck, it is also your future. The 5th house is of your past. The 9th is your future. It is the opportunities we come across, foreign travel, your father, spirituality, higher education, university education, traditions, culture, religion. So the 9th house is a lot of things. But today we're going to be talking about luck. So the zodiac sign that falls in the 9th house, because there are 12 houses and each house has a zodiac sign in it. So the 9th house naturally has a zodiac sign. And whatever zodiac sign falls in the 9th house is going to have a lord. There's going to be a lord of that zodiac. Every zodiac has a lord. For example, Aries, the lord of Aries is Mars, the lord of Taurus is Venus. So I can do a video on that sometime later. So whichever zodiac falls in the 9th house, the lord of that zodiac, wherever it is posited, shows the key to your luck. I've already made 3 videos on this prior to this. So if your 9th lord is in the 1st house, the 2nd house or the 3rd house, then go back, watch those. So if your 9th lord is now in the 4th house, this video is going to, you know, make sense to you. You can use this video to enhance the luck factor in your life. So now, what is the 4th house? Well, the 4th house is a lot of things. The 4th house is your home. The 4th house is your mother. It's your happiness. It's your heart area. It's how happy you are inside, how satisfied you are inside. That is what the 4th house is. It is the vehicles you drive. It is property. Whatever property you buy, it is businesses related to property. The 4th house is your homeland. The 4th house for a politician is the constituency that he contests from. So it's a lot of things. But yes, a couple of things it's common for. It's everybody's mother and it's everybody's home. That's the basic thing that a 4th house is. So now we're going to talk about if your 9th lord is posited in the 4th house. So it has made an immediate connection with your mother. Your luck is immediately connected to your mother. Your luck is immediately connected to your home. So how are you now going to activate it? What is the key to the activation? So that depends on the planet. So now let's talk about the planets. So let's suppose Moon is the lord of the 9th. That can happen in a Scorpio ascendant. So if you are a Scorpio ascendant, your 9th lord is Cancer. And the lord of Cancer is Moon. So if Moon is the lord of the 9th and Moon is posited in the 4th, then what happens? What are you supposed to do? So what is the moon a significator of? Basically, the moon is a significator of our emotions. So it means you need to have that emotional connect with your mother. You need to understand her at an emotional level. She needs your emotional support. Your mother is an emotional person. You too are an emotional person. And you need to connect with her emotionally. That's what she needs from you. And as long as she's happy, as long as she gets the support from you, your luck will be activated and enhanced. Similarly, if Mercury is the lord of the 9th house, that will happen for a Libra ascendant and for a Capricorn ascendant. So if Mercury is the lord of the 9th house and placed in the 4th house, then communication with your mother is the key to your luck. Communication at home and communication with your mother. If Moon was the lord of the 9th, then it was emotions at home and emotion and emotional connect with your mother. If Mercury is the lord, because Mercury is basically the significator of communication. It's a significator of a lot of things, of your intellect, of traveling, driving, of mathematics, of business. So Mercury is a significator of a lot of things in life. But in a relationship, it is a significator of communication. So communicate more, talk to her more often. Tell her of your routine or find out what her routine was every day. Just give her a call every day if she lives a little away from you. Similarly, if Venus is the lord of the 9th and is placed in the 4th house. So what is Venus? Venus is relationship. So just strengthen that bond. Just strengthen that relationship. Nourish that relationship. Venus is luxuries, comforts, art. Everything that is fine in life is Venus. Gift her something. Surprise her something. Gift her a piece of jewelry, a piece of clothing, maybe a shawl or even maybe flowers, anything that makes her smile. So bring that comfort, bring that luxury, bring that happiness to her life. Bring that happiness at home. Have those qualities of Venus at home. Keep your house pretty. Keep your house neat and clean. And you will enhance your luck factor. Similarly, if Saturn is the lord of the ninth and is placed in the fourth house, what is Saturn? Saturn is service. Saturn is your ability of, you know, being of service to others. Be of service to your mother. Do whatever chores she needs to have done. Maybe it's just changing a light bulb or something. Maybe it's buying the grocery. Maybe it's taking her to a doctor's. So whatever is required, just be the legs for her. Be of service to her. Similarly, be of service at home. Don't expect your wife to do all the chores at home. You need to go out and do your bit even at home. Be of service at home. Be like Saturn at home. Saturn is the planet of hard work. And you will activate your luck factor. If Mars is the lord of the ninth house and Mars is posited in the fourth house, so now what happens? Mars is the energy. Mars is the aggression. Mars is strength. Be her strength. Be her energy. You need to support her like that. Make her feel strong. Make her feel you are there for her. Like Hanumanji was there for Ramji, for Bhagwan Ram in Ramayana. So Hanumanji is the Prateek of Mangal. Hanumanji signifies Mars, the planet Mars. So you got to be like that for your mother. You got to stand by your mother. Give her that kind of support, that energy, that strength. Make her feel she has you in the form of strength. If Sun is the lord of the ninth and placed in the fourth house, Sun is a significator of father. Sun is a significator of confidence. Be a father figure at home. Bring that confidence level at home. Bring that confidence level to your mother. Let her feel confident because of you. She should feel confident. Yes, I have this daughter. I have this son. I'm going great guns. That's the feeling she should have when she thinks of you. And your luck is activated. That's all you need to do. You need to be there for her. Give her that strength. Give her that confidence that you are her son or her daughter. That's all you need to do. You need to instill confidence in her. She should not feel weak. She should not be lacking in confidence that, you know, she doesn't have proper support in life. If Jupiter is the lord of the ninth house, posited in the fourth house, it's a beautiful position, lovely position. Jupiter is the planet for nourishment. Jupiter is a guru. Jupiter is a guide. Be there for her, nourish her in every way. She nourished you when you were a child. Now she needs you. Be a nourisher at home. Take care of everything and everyone at home. You're blessed to have such a placement if you have it. It means you yourself are emotionally very stable. It means you're a very happy person with a big heart. That's all that is required. Those are your natural qualities. Just let them flow out. So that is all that is required in this placement. It's a beautiful placement. It's a lovely placement. You will generally be lucky in property. You will generally be lucky at home. So that's all for now. And remember to subscribe below. The subscription button is right here somewhere. So don't forget. Remember to subscribe below if you haven't already. We'll see you in the next video now. Bye-bye for now.